कोविड-19 के कारण हम यह प्रोग्राम ऑनलाइन कर रहे हैं और यह प्रोग्राम 26 आज से स्टार्ट होकर 20 सितंबर तक चलेगा। इस प्रोग्राम के अंदर देश के विभिन्न प्रकाशनों से मेंबर्स आएंगे और आपको किताबों के विभिन्न आयामों के बारे में बताएंगे, जिसमें पांडुलिपि की प्रक्रिया, संपादन, ऑथर एडिटर रिलेशनशिप, ISBN, कॉपीराइट, इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी और ISBN मार्केटिंग और डिजिटल पब्लिशिंग, प्रिंटिंग, प्रोडक्शन, इस सब के बारे में बताया जाएगा। यह हमारी क्लासेस सैटरडे और संडे को 5 बजे से 7 बजे तक चला करेगी और 2 घंटे सैटरडे और संडे को क्लास होगी। यह हमारा प्रोग्राम सन 1994 से चल रहा है और इस प्रोग्राम को हम विभिन्न यूनिवर्सिटियों के साथ कोलैबोरेशन करते हैं और 1 हफ्ते का भी करते हैं और 2 वीक्स का भी प्रोग्राम करते हैं और हम 1 महीने का भी करते हैं। हम दिल्ली में हर साल इस प्रोग्राम को 1 महीने का करते हैं और इस साल हम इसको ऑनलाइन पब्लिशिंग प्रोग्राम 3 महीने का कर रहे हैं, जो कि पहली बार NBT में हो रहा है। इस प्रोग्राम के तहत 15,000 से अधिक स्टूडेंट्स इस कोर्स को कर चुके हैं और देश के विभिन्न प्रकाशन गृहों अच्छे पदों पर कार्य कर रहे हैं। इस ऑनलाइन कोर्स के द्वारा आप लोगों को इसके प्रकाशन की गति को बढ़ाने की में मदद, प्रकाशन की गति को आप लोग इसको आगे ले जाएंगे और प्रकाशन की जो धीमी गति को आगे बढ़ाएंगे। यह ऑनलाइन बुक पब्लिशिंग कोर्स हमारे सबको किताबों के विभिन्न आयाम के बारे में बताएगा और किताबों के जितने भी हमारे आयाम हैं सबकी प्रक्रिया के बारे में आपको जानने का मौका मिलेगा। आप लोग किताब जो लिखने की प्रक्रिया और किताब के विभिन्न किस तरह से इसका प्रोडक्शन होता है, किस तरह से संपादन होता है, किस तरह से इसके डिजिटल कॉपी बनती है, मार्केटिंग किस तरह होती है, ISBN किस तरह लिया जाता है, ISSN किस तरह लेते हैं, इस सब की प्रक्रिया इसमें बताई जाएगी। मैं इसी के साथ सभी का धन्यवाद करता हूं और मैं न्यास के अध्यक्ष महोदय से निवेदन करता हूं कि आप इस मौके पर संबोधित करें सभी पार्टी से। धन्यवाद, नमस्कार।
मित्रों, ये बुक पब्लिशिंग कोर्स के अंदर पूरे देश से जो प्रतिभागी गण सुन रही हैं मेरे को, उन सबको मेरा नमस्कार। जैसा आपको अभी बतलाया गया, पिछले कई वर्षों से राष्ट्रीय पुस्तक न्यास भारत इस बुक पब्लिशिंग कोर्स को कर रहा है। वैसे हम सामान्य परिस्थितियों में भारत के किसी भी विश्वविद्यालय के साथ मिलकर ये बुक पब्लिशिंग कोर्स को अपन करते थे, पर कोविड के कारण कुछ परिस्थितियों में बदलाव आया है और इसलिए स्वाभाविक रूप से ऑनलाइन इस कोर्स को करने का हमने सोचा। यह हमारे लिए पहला अवसर है जब ऑनलाइन कोर्स बुक पब्लिशिंग को लेकर के हम प्रारंभ कर रहे हैं। वैसे इस क्षेत्र के अंदर NBT एक अग्रणी संस्था है, उसके अपने एक्सपर्ट्स हैं जो बुक पब्लिशिंग से जुड़े हुए विभिन्न मुद्दों के ऊपर और विभिन्न पहलुओं के ऊपर आपको पूरी जानकारी देंगे। ये जो वर्तमान समय है ये विशेषज्ञता का समय है। इसमें जो योग्य है, जो जानकार है, जिसका अपना तजुर्बा है, जो सिद्धांत को जानता है, तकनीक को जानता है, मार्केट को समझ सकता है, वही सरवाइव कर पाता है। आपको मालूम है कि अमेरिका का जो पत्रकार है फ्रीडमैन, उसने एक बहुत अच्छा वाक्य कहा था और उसको नारायण मूर्ति ने भी दोहराया और अन्य विचारक भी दोहराते हैं, एवरेज इज ओवर। जो औसत जानकारी को लेकर के बाजार के अंदर कार्य करने वाले लोग हैं उनको अब कोई मौका नहीं है। हर क्षेत्र के अंदर आपको दक्षता चाहिए, उस क्षेत्र की पूरी जानकारी चाहिए। इसको आप स्किल डेवलपमेंट भी कह सकते हैं। जब तक हम उस क्षेत्र के सभी पहलुओं से, सभी नेगेटिव एंड पॉजिटिव जो उसके एस्पेक्ट्स हैं उनसे परिचित नहीं होंगे, तब तक हम उस क्षेत्र के अंदर आगे नहीं बढ़ पाएंगे। और इसलिए हम देख रहे हैं कि बुक पब्लिशिंग के अंदर बहुत कुछ बदला है, बहुत कुछ बदला है। किताबों को छापने की तकनीक बदली है, मार्केट बदला है, लेखक भी बदला हुआ है, पाठक भी बदला हुआ है। हम जो सोचते हैं समाज उससे अलग चाहता है हमसे। तो इन सब चीजों को ध्यान में रख के हम यदि इस क्षेत्र के अंदर आगे बढ़ेंगे तो निश्चित रूप से काफी कुछ सफल हो सकेंगे। और इस प्रकार के ये जो कोर्स किए जाते हैं इनकी यही सबसे बड़ा महत्व है, सबसे बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंस है कि जैसा अभी आपको बतलाया पांडुलिपि लेखन क्या है, संपादन क्या है, प्रकाशन क्या है, रॉयल्टी से जुड़े हुए मामले क्या हैं, कॉपीराइट क्या है, ये सुने तो हैं हमने, मोटे मोटे तौर से थोड़ा थोड़ा जानते भी हैं, लेकिन इनको पूरी तरीके से समझना जिससे कि हम आगे जाकर के कहीं धोखा ना खा पाए, कोई चीटिंग हमसे ना कर पाए और हम अपने कार्य को अच्छी तरीके से कर सके। ये कोर्स इस सब चीज के लिए लाभकारी है। ये भी बात सही है कि फिनोमिना काफी बदल चुका है और ये केवल भारत में बदला है ऐसा नहीं है, प्रिंटिंग के मामले में या अन्य मामलों में भी पूरी दुनिया के अंदर बदला है, पूरी दुनिया। चुनौतियां हैं, काफी कुछ चुनौतियां हैं, वैसे हर क्षेत्र के अंदर, हर व्यापार के अंदर, बिजनेस में चुनौतियां रहती हैं, लेकिन इसके अंदर भी हैं। अब देखिए, पहले ज्ञान का सबसे बड़ा स्रोत पुस्तक हुआ करती थी। हम पुस्तकों से ज्ञान प्राप्त करते थे, वो हमारे साधन थी, लेकिन अब स्थिति बहुत बदल गई है। क्योंकि पहले पुस्तक के साधन थी इसलिए लाइब्रेरीज बहुत थी, उनमें लोगों का जाना बहुत था, उनका महत्व भी बहुत अधिक था। मुझे मालूम है कि हम लोग जब पढ़ते थे तो लगभग प्रत्येक विद्यार्थी के पास अपनी एक डिक्शनरी हुआ करती थी, प्रत्येक विद्यार्थी के पास। आज स्थिति ऐसी है कि डिक्शनरी खरीदने की जरूरत नहीं है। गूगल को बोलिए, वो शब्द की स्पेलिंग बताएगा, वो शब्द का अर्थ बतलाएगा। तो गूगल ने ये सहजता से चीजों को उपलब्ध तो करा दिया, लेकिन उससे बुक पब्लिशिंग मार्केट प्रभावित हो गई। अब इस सब ये जो बदल रहा है, इस बदलते समय में हम अपने आप के एग्जिस्टेंस को बचा करके रखें और उसका विस्तार करें। इसलिए बहुत सी चीजों की जानकारी हमको होना जरूरी है। अब बहुत कुछ है बदला हुआ है, ये बात तो सही है। ई लर्निंग की क्लास बात है, ई क्लास की बात शुरू हो गई, ई टीचिंग शुरू हो गई, ई मार्केट भी शुरू हो गई, ई बैंकिंग भी शुरू हो गई। तो इसमें प्रिंटिंग की आधुनिकतम तकनीक को समझना, उसमें समय भी कम लगेगा, लागत भी कम आएगी, कम समय में अधिक प्रोडक्शन हम कर पाएंगे, अधिक स्थानों पर हम पहुंच पाएंगे। तो इसलिए इस चीज को समझना, प्रिंटिंग टेक्नोलॉजी को जानना, वर्तमान मार्केट को जानना, पाठकों के वर्तमान मनोविज्ञान को जानना, वो किस प्रकार की पुस्तकें चाहते हैं, क्या मोटी मोटी पुस्तकें चाहते हैं कि या थोड़ी एवरेज औसतन पन्नों की पुस्तकें चाहते हैं, लेखक के मन को समझना, रॉयल्टी की चीजों को समझना, जैसा मैंने पहले बतलाया, कॉपीराइट की बात को समझना, और इनको समझना नहीं, इनके अंदर दक्षता प्राप्त करना। ये कुछ ऐसी चीजें हैं जो आपको एक ही स्थान पर इन कोर्स के अंदर मिलेंगी। एनबीटी ने काफी अच्छे एक्सपर्ट्स को चुना है, इसके पहले भी जो कोर्स हुए हैं उसमें वो लेक्चर देने के लिए आते रहे हैं, और जो फीडबैक हमको मिलता रहा अभी तक उसके मुताबिक लोगों ने उनको बहुत एप्रिशिएट किया है। वो तो अपने अपने क्षेत्र के अंदर जानकारी और ज्ञान के पूरे खजाने हैं, उनका लाभ आपको मिलेगा, और आप इस क्षेत्र के अंदर अपनी रुचि जागृत कर सकेंगे। जो लोग नया कार्य प्रारंभ करने वाले हैं उनको बहुत कुछ सुविधाएं सहज रूप से मिल सकेंगी, और ये कोर्स आपको लाभप्रद होगा, आपके व्यापार को बढ़ाने वाला होगा, और आप उसमें सफल होंगे, ऐसी मैं कामना करता हूं। इस मौके पर हमारे नरेंद्र जी बहुत मेहनत करते हैं, पूरा हिंदुस्तान वो घूमते रहते हैं, कोर्स जगह जगह करते हैं, वो भी अब एक नया अनुभव इस प्रकार का ले रहे हैं ऑनलाइन कोर्स कराने का। वे सफल हों, आपकी उम्मीदों को हम पूरा कर सकें, और कोर्स के बाद आप एक अच्छे प्रकाशक के रूप में अपने को स्थापित कर सकें, ऐसी मेरी कामना है। मैं एक बार आपको फिर धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा, और उम्मीद करूँगा कि आपको इस कोर्स से बहुत कुछ मिलेगा। धन्यवाद।
धन्यवाद सर, आपने सर समय निकालकर कुछ शब्द कहे, इसके लिए मैं बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद करता हूं। और मैं अब रियास के निदेशक श्री युवराज मलिक साहब से निवेदन करता हूं कि वो पार्टिसिपेंट्स को संबोधित करें।
वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू, रेस्पेक्टेड चेयरमैन नेशनल बुक ट्रस्ट ऑफ इंडिया प्रोफेसर गोविंद शर्मा जी, माय एस्टीम्ड एंड एमिनेंट फैकल्टी, Chief Editor Kumar Vikram ji, the Project Director Narendra ji, and the entire silent players, the technical backup team, and all the NBT staff. I welcome you all and congratulate this first time ever historic opportunity. Then, when we are going to start कोर्स विच इज ऑनलाइन. सो फार इट हैज बीन ट्रेडिशनली ऑफलाइन पर्सनल इंटरफेस एजुकेशन मॉड्यूल. नाउ एज इनिशिएटिव वी हैव स्विच्ड ओवर टू ऑनलाइन मॉड्यूल. विदाउट टेकिंग मच टाइम एज आवर चेयरमैन हैज very nicely and briefly summarize all the key aspects of transition which literature world is going, and especially the publication industry, how it is facing the challenges, how we have overcome, and how the transformation is required. I will sum up on the basically curriculum of this course, how we are going to do it. Let me assure you at the outset, the best of the faculties will be available to you, where you can have a dialogue. It won't be a monologue. Whatever queries you have, the curiosities you have or doubts you have, we will be more than welcome to address them to the best of our abilities. And where we feel there is a gap, we won't hesitate to add on a new faculty to fill that gap. Second most important aspect in sequence two is that every lecture we take, every discussion we have, it will be evaluated independently. And we will seek a feedback from you. How are our instructors? How was the lecture? What it was missing with, so that we can upgrade it for the next courses. And this enhancement is a continuous exercise and it should not stop. So the value addition is not from our side. We will seek in value addition from our participants as well. So please feel free and contribute to the best of your understanding. Another point which I want to highlight is, whenever we have some topics or issues which need further elaboration, we are not bound by the number of lectures and the duration of it. If it requires more emphasis, we are very flexible and we will have additional sessions, additional classes, even beyond the call of the curriculum. So there will not be any vacuum and all your queries will be suitably taken care of. During this assessment exercise, we will try to put a small WhatsApp group or a group where we can communicate with you directly, and free and fair, you can give your feedback about the complete conduct. And whatever modulations in the due course of the course is needed, we will take the necessary corrections in that. In the publication industry, let me tell you, NBT is the benchmark. We are the standard which people look up to. Being a national body where people look up as a national institution, responsibility is very high. And I assure you, NBT will not leave any stone unturned to live up to that reputation, where we have to lead the entire publishing industry. Being the nodal agency, being the coordinator, being the spokesman of all publications, the best of the practices, best of the people, best of the content will be made available to you. Anyone of you who is free and feel that he has something to add, we won't mind, even a learner, a course qualifying person, to be part of faculty at the same time and is part of the student faculty also. So please feel free, if you want to contribute, we'll give you that particular time, 10, 15 minutes, who wants to contribute and give your experience. In the end of it, I will say, about the course and curriculum, we have tried to touch upon each aspect, from production, from marketing, from sales, from content, from writing. The most beautiful part about publication industry is everything is in an assembly line. Everything starts with a concept note. When you get a concept note, how the book is generated, so try to understand as a process. Never try to learn this thing as a leaf. Piecemeal method, let's learn today about production. No, production starts only when a concept has been generated. So don't break this flow of thought which you develop, because end of the course you'll realize it's just such a simple exercise. How to start from an idea till the last production of a book and putting into the market. So this complete process is a very, very scientific and systematic process. Please follow that and go with that. Lastly, without taking much time, this is an inaugural session, most of the things have been covered. I will just tell you, we are the esteemed body where country is looking up to us to give the direction to the publishing industry. And we say direction to the public industry, that means all the practices which we have been following here, we are free. If any one of you after the termination of course wants to come and see on ground how things are happening, to make your assimilation much better understanding, I will request you go to YouTube, to go to various multimedia platforms where you can read and have more lectures so that you understand what we are talking about. A lot of policies of the government are under change. Please refer to them and keep yourself updated with the latest policies on the publication and especially the production part of it. There are many issues which are related to the regulatory mechanism, the marketing mechanism, the policies, the exports, they are very, very fragile and dynamic in nature. If you have to be relevant in this industry, you have to be updated. It can't be what we teach you. We teach you only a standard template. We can't give you a specified solution to everything. No, we are not going to give you any solutions. We are going to tell you how to get a solution. We are going to teach you the process. We are going to teach you the methodology. At the end of the day, the product will be your own understanding, how you create that. So I again repeat, it's a two-way exercise. Your contributions are valuable. Give your premium feedbacks, give your advisories, give your suggestions. We are open to your suggestion and ideas. Incorporate and let's make this unique course, first time ever in 3 months of online course, one of the most pioneer course. So this batch in front of me is the pioneer batch of NBT with 3 months of online program. So once again, I congratulate and convey my best wishes to all participants, faculty and everyone. And sum it up, because I have one more interaction after this with you, which I will talk in detail about books and other things. Thank you so much, and I wish you all the best to the entire. And I hand over to the control. Please take over.
I joined National Book Trust India in year 2000 as an editorial assistant, and that was March 2000. And in July 2000, we had this publishing course organized by our trust. And we were two or three new recruits. We were asked to attend this book publishing course. And there was one talk by Professor Mushirul Hassan, the eminent historian who was later also the vice chancellor of Jamia, on what the author expects from the publisher. And I must say that it was a cultural shock to me, because, you know, when you are studying and the books come to you as a kind of a sacred text, where books are ultimate thing, the authors are ultimate things. But here an eminent author was telling us that the editors should be able to guide the authors about the new trends which are emerging in the publishing arena. They should be able to guide the authors about how the books should be projected, how the chapter plans should be projected, and how a kind of a new ideas which the authors should be looking at and bring through a publishing house. That was a kind of a shocking statement, but later on that showed us the kind of responsibility which is on an editor in a publishing house. And in the same course, there was a chap from OUP who said that if I equate the publishing world with the film industry world, then we can say that the publisher is the producer, because the producer is putting the money. The editor is the director of the film, because he is directing. And in some sense, the author is the actor. But this is a controversial thing, he added, because author is not going to completely act as the editor or the producer would want. But once the script is given by the author, the author has to rely upon what the editor is trying to tell him, because it is the editor's responsibility to bring out the latent energy, the latent message which is hidden in the manuscript. In that connection, the idea is to say that the editor should be able to talk to the author on equal terms. And that, of course, means that editor should be intellectually strong. I will give you two examples. I don't want to take much of time, but I will give you only two examples. One is of T.S. Eliot and Ezra Pound. And T.S. Eliot, one of the most eminent poets, he wrote his Wasteland is almost 100 pages. And he gave it to Ezra Pound, who was a contemporary poet and critic. And Ezra Pound, after editing it, reduced it to 25 pages. And that is a documented thing. You can go to the libraries and you can see how Ezra Pound edited the entire manuscript of the Wasteland, the poem which turned the entire tide of English literary poetry. And then we have back home, we have another eminent pair of Premchand and Shivpujan Sahai. Premchand's manuscripts were used to be edited by his contemporary writer and critic Shivpujan Sahai, and you can still find in the libraries the manuscript of Godan, which was edited by Shivpujan Sahai, cutting many paragraphs, adding his comments, asking the writer to merge some chapters, and that is how the Godan came into being. In this connection, I would like to also underline that you should get hold of the memoirs and autobiographies of the publishing heads. One of them I would suggest is Frederick Warbook, who was the publishing head of Secker and Warbook. He is the person who found authors like George Orwell. He worked with Kafka. He worked with Andre Gide. And if you look at his autobiography, you will find the way the editors have been able to, you know, bring out the best of the classic materials, the way it comes out before the reader. So this is a kind of experience I wanted to share with you as an editor of National Book Trust India for more than two decades. So even though we are going to the online mode, what I wanted to say that the medium may have changed, but the basic responsibilities and the role of the editor remains the same. And I'm sure that in the coming lectures, you will be given more insights into not only editing, but also different parts, different sections of book publishing. Thank you. Thanks for this opportunity.
फिर से सभी को मेरा नमस्कार. नरेंद्र जी, आपने मुझे टॉपिक दिया है रोल ऑफ एनबीटी इन इनकल्केटिंग बुक माइंडेडनेस. तो सबसे पहले तो मैं चाहूंगा कि आपको सभी को इस चीज का ज्ञान हो कि एनबीटी क्या है और एनबीटी का रोल क्या है. एनबीटी का मायने है नेशनल बुक ट्रस्ट. फर्स्ट वर्ड इज नेशनल. दैट इटसेल्फ स्पीक्स दैट इज द सुप्रीम बॉडी इन द कंट्री एंड हैज अ नेशनल रोल टू प्ले. वी अंडरस्टैंड इट वेरी क्लियरली. वी आर अ नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशन एंड आवर रोल इज नेशनल. बट लेट मी टेल यू, एक्चुअली इट्स अ इंटरनेशनल बुक ट्रस्ट. Because the presence which we have in India is much more than abroad also. We participate in all the hemisphere of the world, all the major countries. We participate in all the events related to book all over world. Our teams go represent and tell what literature we do, and we represent the entire publishing industry as a nodal agency. Second word comes book. Of course, that's what we all are, the common link is. And the last word is trust. It is not the trust which is like any registered body. I look at it in a different manner. For me, it is a matter of faith, the credibility. This trust is directly linked to credibility, faith, and commitment. The National Book Trust of India is committed to perform its role towards book, keeping in the center of gravity the book culture. As per so-called mandate, we have mandate of promoting book reading culture in the country by creating inculcating habits, by making people read more books and providing them literature at affordable pricing. When we talk about NBT books, it is taken about three things. Firstly, affordability. Our books are highly affordable in nature. Very rarely you'll find in the market anyone competing with that price list, because we are not here for profit making. We are here to create the content and take it to the people. Second aspect which you can identify NBT with is quality of content. The content is so qualitative that we are taken in most of the books, if you see even in UPSC, as a reference book. Many of our books are taught in all the coaching institutes, the academic institutions, many research institutes. And even when you are telling your children to pick up a book reading habit, they are used as a reference guide. Be the books in research content, be the book on children reading, or be the books of illustrations. We have endless publications, thousands and thousands of titles with us. And the most important and beautiful thing is we publish in almost every Indian language. आप ये नहीं कह सकते कि आपने उनके लिए publish नहीं किया. Not only Indian, we are also publishing in many foreign languages, be it Chinese or Korean or other languages. So let me tell you, we address the book reading need of the country in spite of the diversification, cultural and social differences and social diversification in the nation. So the content, there is something for everyone in NBT. So that is what we are doing. Now, how do we do it? Under the Ministry of Human Resource Development, when they say human resource development. So this wing has a very integral role to play in human resource development. And the human resource is our children, our students, our people. No, any country which ignores its manpower, its human resource, can never reach achieve. And what they understand and they become is the responsibility of the literature they read. The literature is a reflection of the society. What content we produce, what content we take to people, is a very high sense of responsibility which we understand, and that is why we are very, very particular when we produce a book. The content is screened at multiple levels, which includes our editorial board, then it goes to expert committee, then we have reviewers, and the final supreme body under the chairman of National Book Trust takes a call. Is the book matching the standard? What impact it will have? What message we want to give? How are the facts? What class of audience we are targeting? We can't publish book for adults. We have to publish book from 0 to 18 and from 18 to 80. So that is the kind of mandate we are fulfilling in the country to create a book reading culture. Then comes the question of language. Then comes question of gender. Then question of the domains which are totally untouched. Nobody wants to write about folklore of Bastar. We do that. Nobody wants to write about Kutch. We do that. Nobody wants to write about the far-flung stories of Arunachal. We do that. So anything and everything which is quality in content, it doesn't matter how many people read it. We have to take out the quality content from the dark rooms to the public. Then only people will know what book reading is and people will be more involved. Now comes how we do it. We have many tools to execute our mandate. The first tool which we have is we do a lot of exhibitions. Exhibitions in both formats, static and mobile. For mobile exhibition, we have a lot of vans which are modified. We carry our titles into them, laid out for exhibition. And these mobile vans go to the places where no one goes. Our more focus is on the rural area where the penetration of book publishing is very, very less. So these books with their staff go to the hinterland, go to the interiors of maybe Red Corridor or maybe North or maybe Northeast. Every corner we are crisscrossing. And we are committed to do that. Then comes the static exhibitions. Almost every stage we are doing 2 to 3 exhibitions independently, at least 2 exhibitions per month at national level. And also we do participate in the exhibitions being conducted by various bookseller promotions, associations and societies. So that also we participate and ensure that affordable reading is not affected to anyone. Another tool and mechanism what we have is when we are producing book, we need professionals. So we're conducting a lot of online courses now as a first course. Prior to that, we have been doing courses in person in collaboration with various universities. Hundreds and thousands of professionals have graduated from our courses and they are serving in different publishing houses with credibility and commitment, and the quality of work they deliver in this industry where there are no professionals easily available. We are committed to fulfill that mandate also. Now question comes about book reading. How to promote book reading? Prior to that comes the question of book writing. We have many schemes, many provisions where we take up the projects which are generally not commercially very, very viable, but the content is absolutely essential for the society. So we give priority to the content, not the commercial viability. On that, we have taken hundreds of projects which has come into the line. And people have become author only because NBT is committed to do its mandate. We will not hesitate to take more projects which are quality driven, may not be commercially viable. That is the thing I want to assure you. One more thing I want to tell you, other than these exhibitions, we have national and international events like New Delhi Book Fair, where lakhs of people come, almost 1 lakh people on an average at peak times, almost more than 1,000 publishers. Stalls, they are organized under one roof. Almost all languages are represented. All age groups are coming. Children, disabled, differently abled people, all kind of community people, they come and participate in that book fair. Not only this, almost every hemisphere we have participated. And book fair. So we take the message of our country, rich cultural heritage in terms of academics and books. We take it to the world and tell them the quality of content which India has to offer to the world. So that is the job NBTI has been doing very, very successfully. And let me endorse our chief editor, Kumar Vikram, and the entire team of us has been doing a commendable job to take our mandate across the globe, not only in India. Now, there was a time a few months back when this crisis happened. So we had a very dilemma, what to do? Offices are closed, everything is shut down, people are in their walls. What NBTI has to do? So we had a brainstorming. As a national institution, we realized what we should publish. If we would have been publishing rosy stories at this time or fictions, it would have been injustice to the mandate which we have. So the mandate was, when there are hard times, what literature we are going to produce. So we decided to take a publication on Corona. You will be surprised to know and feel proud that NBTI is the only institution in the world which has come up with a series of 7 books in 30 days. No one has done it so far in the world. So this is the prestige which we feel proud of, and the team NBTI, which is doing a commendable job. This all happened online. Taking off experts of psychologists, panelists, counselors on board, taking their content, doing a lot of sample survey, Corona studies series of 7 books, the psychosocial impact of Corona and how to cope up with it. We have a specific book for children, for working people, for parents, for old people, for coronavirus, and there are very specific takeaways from that. So as a zero baseline case study, which NBTI took and put it across to the people, has been acknowledged across the country. Our minister, our ministries, various platforms, you pick up newspaper, they're talking about what we have been talking 3 months back. Role of yoga, role of joint family system, the power of meditation, the power of routine, good food, joint value system, and more than that, impetus on national mental health framework. We were talking 3 months back. The country is talking now. So we gave this literature to people, and you'll be surprised, we were the first one also to upload free downloading of the books. More than hundreds of books were uploaded for free downloading, and more than 50,000 people took the benefit of it. Free of cost, because initially people didn't know what to do when they are in lockdown. So I believe books are the best friends. So 50,000 people on our call have chosen books as their best friend. On the same lead, our minister also took initiative. He himself is a big writer of around 75 books he has written, very keen reader. He started a campaign, My Book, My Friend. So taking clue from our minister's campaign of My Book, Friend, NBTI also jumped into it and took it to people and motivated children to read more books and write. So we organized many sessions with various schools, in which we are happy to announce that many schools participated, and we organized the essay competition, My Book, My Friend. So every school has got 3 award winners in the participants. So more than 20,000 people have taken this lead, and we have awarded books and certificates from the ministry and the NBTI side for their efforts to pick book reading and write content on My Book, My Friend. So this is where we have to understand, go beyond the call. We just can't be publishing house. If nobody reads, for whom we will publish? If there's no consumer, our consumer is knowledge. Knowledge is our product. If you don't read, for whom I'm going to publish? Unless and until I develop a habit in you to read first, then only my content will have the resemblance and the relevance. This is what we did. And this campaign, Stay with Books India. So we started and it went beautifully. A lot of people participated and we could achieve what we were expecting to do it. Now, these are some of the things which we did. Now the question comes, what next? What next is the world had changed. The format of book had changed. The content is still same, only the methodology and technology had changed. Initial books were very bulky, hardbound. They became pocket books, paperback. The price reduced, but the content is same. Then came the technology. Then they become Kindle and e-books. Now we have to understand, we cannot totally stay aloof to the change the world is undergoing. The world is changing very drastically. So we have to be very, very relevant. We have to upgrade ourselves. We have to be awake to the need of the society. So we have also jumped and very aggressively we are very well placed into e-books. Most of our titles are in the process of being available on e-books. So that's what NBT is evolving and addressing the need of the market also. The necessity to address the market is for two reasons. If our consumer, the book reader, the keen book reader, want a book in e-format and we are not providing, our content will become irrelevant. So the content has relevance only and only when it reaches through the right medium at the fastest mode that the readers are want. So you have to understand the viability of the concept when you think what format you book you are going to produce, in what quantity you are going to produce, in what is the mode of dissemination. That call has to be taken. Now, when you produce the content, how you take and keep it to the people? So if I have written a book and nobody is reading it, not because they are not readers, not because we are not able to reach to people. So how to reach out? So we did one more experiment. We picked up the best of the books and chosen them and picked up many people who are good storytellers. So we did a tie-up with Prasar Bharati. Morning and evening, we had one-hour session tie-up. And the best of our highest-selling books were put into storytelling method. Because when people are not reading, they are listening. And it is easy. If you're a good storyteller, you can make this normal thing look amazing. An amazing thing can die within few seconds if you're a bad storyteller. So the both medium and means, they are important to achieve the right objective. This project has been taken very well by the society and people have really admired that. And we are glad to tell that there's a very heavy demand of this content and this association with Prasar Bharati is getting viral. More than 20 schools have joined whose students want to become storyteller now after these sessions. They want rights from our book to read and perform on YouTube, Facebook. Facebook Live, we did it. Now, these things we have been doing simultaneously. The question arises, what about the industry as such? What we thought about that? Because we are the nodal agency. Everyone looks up to us. We set the benchmark. We set the standards. What NBT is doing, people look up to us. So firstly, we had a big seminar of all the publication houses, all the associations under FICCI, a joint seminar, and realized what is the fate and how the publishing industry is going to change. What were the changes we expected, how we should address them, and what is the response and role NBT has to play. So that we carried out with FICCI, and you'll be surprised the kind of inputs and understandings which we received from them. Those valuable inputs we implemented, and it is glad, I'm very absolutely heartening to say that even in lockdown, we have produced more than 20 books. People were more than keen to get back to the routine life. So the content creation, book reviews, the typesetting work, which can be done from home, was carried out. But the process does not stop. Only the production part was stopped, which is the physical printing production. The moment first lockdown happened, the very first day, the books were in the market. So my point is, it's a very dynamic world. Publishing industry is very dynamic. If you are not alive, you'll be left out. As our chairman has very rightly said, average is over. If your eyes, ears, and environmental understanding is not clear in this profession, the content will change very quickly. There was a time when Raja Wazir ki kahaniya, wo sab aap suna karte thi. Mythological stories ka ek era tha. Phir fictions aayi, phir crime story chali. Ek beech mein bahut era aayi tech fictions ki, wo chali. Phir biographies ne sar pakda. Ab aap technology pe aa gaye hain, artificial intelligence ke bare mein aa gaye hain. In sab pe baat karne lage. Ab main aapko bolta hoon, that era is going to be about behavioral science, the mental and the kind of impact corona will have on the society. People are forced to think what they should do. They are reading about lifestyle disease. They are reading about the pattern and behavioral changes, mental health, how to stay out of depression. They are reading about it. You'll be surprised. It's a very interesting development. In last 1 year of survey in America, which we have seen, almost 15% demand of the books pre-corona has declined on e-books. Now people want to have more of hardbound print books because they feel 24/7 they are working on computer. they are watching TV again on a screen. Their life is stick to the screen, which is affecting their mental neurons. So that behavioral pattern they are facing, so they are switching back to hardbound books. This is the new case studies which are coming up, and I'm telling you, in days to come you will read, people want to go back to books. So when the people say hardbound will be irrelevant, no, it is not. In fact, I feel the demand will rise again. Yes, temporarily we are curtailed into our four walls. There are no means to go on market. It is against the health issues. That's why people see there's a high demand of online books. But the kind of online infiltration, the technology will has invasion on our lives, books will remain relevant. At the same time, one more school of thought. Should we reject the e-books? No. We have to have a balance. Both will have their own space. E-books industry will rise at its own pace. Publication hardbound copies, they will have their own space. So we have to have this coordination. This ratio has to be maintained so that the book industry understands and fulfill both the demands. So when we produce a book, we have to be very clear what ratio will go into the hardbound publications or the print publication, and how many, what percentage will be for the e-books. So you cannot afford to ignore any one of the domain. Both domain will go hand in hand and in synergy. One more aspect which I would like to share with you at this point of time is the kind of manpower in book reading. When you go to a bookstore, remember the face of that person. He will show you 10 books. You have not read the book. So you ask, ki bhaiya kaun si kitab achhi hai? Madam, ye le jao, ye bahut achhi hai. Sir, ye le jao, ye bahut achhi hai. He himself is selling books, his 10th pass and 12th pass, and he is telling this book is good. What an irony it is all about. We have to understand, when we have to tell a client why they should read your book. It can't be the recommendation of the Kitabwala Bhaiya in a narrow street and telling an expert on a book on physics. He's telling you only on one parameter, by the number of books he sells. If a book is selling more, he thinks this is a good book. If I am able to manage a book placed in a stall and tell him ki becho 20% commission jada milega, so that book will automatically qualify to be the best book into the stall. We have to tell people what is a good quality content. So that's what I want you to understand. So publishing is not only the printing part. It starts from concept note till the book reaches to the hand. And not even reading. Post-reading, do we seek a book review? Do we take the feedback on our book? What kind of content we created? How people took it? Where did we miss out? How did we place? How did we do the marketing? How did we go for sales? How did we do the promotion? And more important, other than this, for example, take an editorial example about book reading, which I have realized. You see the headline. If you find an editorial headline interesting, you go into the editor. For example, a few days back, yoga, community, immunity, and unity. It's very catchy. People go and read it. Then yoga, Uttam Yog. No one will read. What a mediocre article. The caption is more important. As good as the content, as good as is the cover. Cover will attract you and content will keep your stick. Please understand. Cover may pull you to the stall, but the content will make you buy. You have to understand not only the publication and packaging, the packaging of material is equally important, as important as the content. Please ensure in your thing, and when say packaging, the quality of paper, the quality of printing, the quality of fabric, color, everything counts into that. So these are the few domains I wanted to touch at this point of time. In due course, I'll be talking more about specific things on specific domain, on one day on editorial, or someday on, I will talk about marketing strategies, someday on production cycles. And I'm telling you this because as a director, I'm not handling one domain. So this is a wheel. I get an order of books from XYZ, and how I take this order and how it goes back and how the feedback comes, it's a complete cycle of 90 days from inception to delivery. So how 90 days you have to monitor and keep a track of everything. So whichever domain you want to go into, you have to be very clear. First, understand the process. Again, I repeat, you must understand the process. If you understand the chapter, you may not be a very successful person. First, understand the process, then choose the chapter, and then do the expertise in that. Because it's a chain. If one link is missing, the vehicle will not move ahead. You will get stagnant at one place. So publishing industry is assembly line which can run only well if everyone in the chain is able to deliver. Coming back to the mandate of NBT, I would like to tell you, you must look up to NBT for new standards. India will be 75 after 1 year. In 2022, we will be completing 75 years of independence. And NBT is going to come a big time publications, especially in last 75 years, how India had changed. Who are the people who has changed the history and dynamics of the country? What are those 75 events which have redefined our historic perspective? What are those 75 places? What are 75 contexts in terms of history, geography, and incidences which shaped us all together? Our history gets stopped at 47. So we have 75 years is a long time. So we have to give that authentic content which country needs at this point of time. So there's a serious need on this subject. So we are working on that, and we tell you that we will be able to fulfill the expectations the country has, the society has, and especially the book industry has from us. We assure you, we'll keep our affordable, quality, high content book reading culture alive in this country and promote this national institution internationally and ensure the trust has its people's faith and trust by all means. Thank you so much for listening me so patiently. I congratulate you for participating in this pioneer course. I'm sure you will achieve, and wherever there's a need to step in, I'm always available. You can shoot your queries, email, and we will reciprocate to them within no time. Thank you so much.